Are you ready? Go ahead.
Yeah. Okay. My name is Roberto Manfredini. I come from Italy. And I'm full professor of internal medicine. And I am the director of the Clinica Medica unit, a 24-bed unit in the General Hospital of Ferrara, and also the head of the Department of Medical Science of all the University of Ferrara. Was born in 1391. I started attend this Congress in 2008. And I miss only a couple of editions. I'm very familiar and I love very much this conference. It represents a unique occasion in the worldwide area of cardiology congress, where usually we are 30,000, 20,000, and we can establish new friendship, new collaborations for ourselves, but also for our staff and our research fellows and our groups. Okay, I just presented this morning a study entitled Daylight Saving Time and Myocardial Infarction. Is a gender-oriented difference or relationship exist? In particular, I was very happy to present this data in Boston because the first fan of a possible DST in 1784, and through a publication, a letter to the editor of the Journal of Paris in favor of this possibility to save money was Benjamin Franklin, a well-known Bostonian. He had no success because that idea was not accepted, but the DST was established in Europe in 1960 due to the energy saving for the World War II. And a few months ago, the European Parliament had a great debate to abolish or not the DST. In particular, Finland asked to abolish. And it's singular because Finland is a country with low sun. And they asked to abolish DST due to a lot of complication, in particular to the health costs and disease. And one of the possibilities of disruption of circadian rhythms is cardiovascular disease and myocardial infarction. And the first paper on this problem was published in New England in 2008 by the group of investigators from the Karolinska Institute in Sweden. And they showed an association between a higher incidence of myocardial infarction after the spring shift, in particular in women. So we reviewed all the evidence in the world, and there are only 6 studies worldwide, not so much. Another study from the Karolinska Institute, further, one in Germany, one in Croatia, and 2 in the US. And they all, different studies, different methodologies, not possible to make, for example, some meta-analysis of these studies. But they all pointed at an increase in ranging from 5% to 25% in the occurrence of myocardial infarction after the spring shift. And we have to remember that the circadian rhythm comes from the Latin circa diem, about 24 hours, is the time of a complete Earth rotation. But it's slightly longer than 24 hours. So our body prefers a longer day than a shorter day. For example, the jet lag, west is best and east is least. Flying west, you gain 1 hour and your body adjusts well. To this. Maybe this is an explanation why spring shift is more dangerous. In particular, other studies did not confirm preference for women. But there is no attention, not enough attention until now to a separate analysis by gender. And we need further studies with separate analysis by gender. In particular, sleep deprivation seems to be one of the most explanations, even if of one single hour. But sleep deprivation may cause a lot of consequences, also on the metabolic point of view, and expose some people to a risk of myocardial infarction. In my opinion, before abolish, the European Parliament vote not to abolish, but year by year to check the scientific evidence and decide. And I agree with accumulating evidence, but a campaign for educational people, for example, to pre-adapt in the few days before, in particular elderly, adolescents, and at risk period, to adapt to a new hour, it will be a first and inexpensive way solution.